during our son's senior year, we began to detect an issue with drinking.
I started smoking weed when I was 12. About 14, 15 is when I started drinking regularly.
I wasn't showing up to work. I wasn't able to hold a relationship.
I always was blacking out. I always was throwing up.
We were alerted to the fact that there was a psychological issue involved and not only an addiction issue, which we didn't know how to deal with.
I had two seizures trying to withdraw from alcohol. From there, I really started trying to quit. I started going to, multiple treatment centers.
You know, most people say, oh, 30 days, you're out. Then what?
I was really, really afraid that I was just going to be a bad person for the rest of my life.
When I first arrived to this house, I found a place that was like a home instead of an institution.
I showed up in dress attire, basically. I presented myself as someone with not a whole lot of problems. They quickly saw through that.
What it felt like from the staff was just unconditional love. You can't burn a bridge here. They will still be there.
The trust that I was able to give to my therapist, I've never trusted another person like that in my life.
While Mario was here, I heard from his therapist weekly, and anytime there was any kind of an issue, which again reinstilled in us that confidence and that trust that the network was not going to fail him.
To know that you can come to a treatment facility that not only cares about you while you're in the program, but for the rest of your life, I think sets us apart.
The lengths that people go to here to help, I mean, they saved my life, they changed my life.
Addiction is really a symptom of other core issues that they need to address. Maybe it's depression. For a lot of our patients, it's trauma, attachment fraction. If you don't get to that and help someone reorganize and restructure how that is in their own psyche and their own brain, then the symptom of that, which is addiction and numbing, is just going to return itself. So what we're trying to do is address the core issue and help them access that and cope with it in a different way instead of cope with it with drugs and alcohol.
That's the difference between Ascend and the other treatment programs. They provided me the space and a place to feel comfortable talking about the sexual abuse that I experienced as a child. That was a secret I was planning on taking to my grave.
This is all-encompassing, the whole person, and not just the addiction. Mario's success today is based on that.
Ascend was able to assist me in thinking differently about it. It took a lot of digging deep and looking inward, which I hadn't looked inward ever throughout my life.
Most people, if they're even mildly willing, do exceptionally well in a residential environment, but it's not a predictor of long-term success because oftentimes as they leave that high-structured environment, it just doesn't translate into the real world.
There's a difference between rehab and recovery, and I think rehab needs to be a solid foundation, but the program needs to help people get into and be in recovery, not just how can you graduate the program.
Most programs have two phases, inpatient and sober living. They don't have that transitional phase where you're actually taking what you've learned in inpatient and applying it, but still having the structured support and the accountability that you need in order to be able to transition to sober living.
You can get sober a lot of ways, but they want you to live a happy lifestyle that you can be proud of.
Our real commitment to patients is that we're not just there for the rehab process, we're there for the actual recovery process that gets harder, that gets messier, that's more complicated. And we're going to be there for that because our real mission is to get you into recovery in a year sober, not just graduated from the program.
So whenever they leave, we will call them weekly for a month and monthly for a year. We'll also offer things to do. We do women's retreats, men's retreats, reunions, holiday parties, and even as simple as just going up in the mountains and hiking in our beautiful surroundings.
One of the key pieces to recovery are out there really giving back to the community and involved in service in ways that are way bigger than Ascend. We have alumni that participated in a big service project down in Monument Valley. A lot of them participated. We do workshops with a foundation called the Riley Foundation. Sure, part of the mission for people to get sober, but when they're really accessing all those different things that we see our alumni do once they get sober, that's the piece that really gets me up in the morning and gets me ready to work with that next person. The families are a massive part of someone's recovery, and we know families have gone through an incredible struggle. We want to help them in the recovery process too.
We have families come out every other week, or at least have the opportunity for them to come out every other week. And so we are able to not only work on your addiction, but we're able to work on the effects of how addiction has affected the whole family system.
And at a very minimum, we're going to talk to them once a week. We're going to call them. We're going to say, this is where we're at. This is what you need to do as a family member if you want to be helpful and supportive.
Not only is your loved one changing, but you're actually doing work and changing too.
Seeing him today, we're happy that he's got the full-time job, got the roommate, got the apartment, and is feeling much better about himself. We feel that Ascend saved him, saved us.
That's the gift that I got from Ascend, was a clear mind, a way of thinking that I didn't know was possible, a way to wake up each morning excited for the day, positive. You know, I can look myself in the mirror each night and be proud of who I've become.
These are some of the most important people in my life. And this is one of the most important places in my life.
We're able to see people who come in the door at the point at which they say, like, I don't know what the point is anymore. I'm a lost cause. I'm a hopeless case. End up turning it around and living lives that they never imagined they would have had. I firmly believe that no matter how far gone you think you are, you can come back from it.